Hello, friends, and welcome back to r/ProRevenge. Let's start our video with a warm-up story. Then there's a long one for you, my lovely subscribers. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you're new here and turn on notifications so you don't miss a new video every single day. Here we go. No, keep going. I'm sure you'll seal the deal. I had yet another one of those people calling me to get me to sign up to a new electricity provider. I usually don't see any reason to be rude, but I'll simply decline what they have to offer. This time they kept pushing, as is tradition. I declined their offer 3 times. He seemed eager to continue his monologue though, and since I obviously was not interested, I figured my presence wasn't really important. I put my phone down and walked away. Seems like he continued for a good minute or two before hanging up. He must really have had a lot to talk about. And our next story. Supervisor planned to fire me after I helped secure a multi-million dollar client, so I made him lose the client, then his job. I've worked in marketing for 7 years. That entire time, I've worked for one company. I'm one of only 3 females in a male-dominated department of about 15. My job basically entails courting big brands into choosing our agency to create their advertising campaigns. Lots of spreadsheet work, profit projections, boring stuff for people not in the industry. I was in the industry and I'm bored just typing a general description of it. The entire time I was with the company, Dan was my boss. Dan was a mid-level manager who reports to the vice president of the entire company. There are 5 other Dans for the office, all of whom run their own departments, handling their own big clients. Like I said, I was in the middle of the pack my whole career. I never aspired to get promoted, but over the years, I noticed Dan promote all sorts of people around me. For those who clearly did more and better work, it made perfect sense. If I did something mostly on my own, Dan made sure credit was shared with the whole department. That's cool. But if the entire team didn't do well, he'd single me out or single out some other poor schmuck to take the rap for the whole thing. Dan would then write an after-action report where that person got the lion's share of the blame and eventually got fired. Whether our team exceeded its goal or not, Dan would make sure he and his favorites got fat bonuses. One thing Dan believed in was going out on team-building lunches. At these lunches, the team made sure to be on our guard, only 1 drink apiece, watch your tongue, that sort of thing. But Dan would always get roaring drunk and say all kinds of non-PC stuff. Dan's favorite thing was guy jokes. I mean, guy humor. The other 2 girls in our department seemed to like that sort of thing and didn't mind. I minded, but kept my big mouth shut because I didn't want to cause trouble. Well, eventually a friend of mine from another department came to me and he told me that he overheard Dan and his, my friend's, supervisor talking about who was on the chopping block next. I have a good friend in HR, and on a lunch date a few days later, she told me that it was true. I was one of the names submitted by Dan for termination in the near future. She swore me to secrecy, and I promised I wouldn't say a word. But I also made her promise she wouldn't say a word about what I was planning. I remember how much of a jerk Dan was and that he wouldn't even let me take my 2 weeks off to get married 2 years ago, even though I requested it several months in advance without making me feel like a lazy jerk. I just realized I was pregnant with my first child and I dreaded eventually having to ask Dan for my maternity leave. This job really wasn't making me a happy person anyway, and my husband makes a fine salary and has always told me it's perfectly fine for me to take time off to be a stay-at-home mom for a few years, or even permanently if I want. Growing up with 2 a-hole brothers who are now wonderful people, one teaches high school English and the other's a chemist, I knew a lot about the classic mousetrap stink bomb trick, where you superglue a stink bomb ampule to the cheese area of a mousetrap and set the mousetrap so that when the trap is triggered, it crushes the ampule and releases the fart and rotten egg smell. I decided that I would ruin Dan's presentation with a stink bomb. That would be annoying, but it wouldn't really be revenge for 7 years of him treating me like crap and making me do all this work that ultimately he took credit for and gave himself raises for. So in the next 4 weeks, 3 times a week, Dan and our entire team would be that obnoxious group of office workers you see at Chili's or Red Robin or whatever mid-price sit-down restaurant you have near you that's a step up from Denny's. Per usual, Dan would talk about what losers people in other departments were, how the company was nothing without him, how the boss's new wife was hotter than the previous wife, and how he banged both. We all knew he was just messing around and just bro-talking. Whatever he was doing with all his drunk talk, I thought maybe upper management would be a better judge than me. I thought of just emailing the best audio files to them. I didn't mention before, but I had gotten into the habit these last few weeks of quietly hitting record audio whenever Dan decided to tell off-color jokes, sex jokes, or make fun of differences between black and white people. How funny it sounds when Asian people speak English, and so on. My friend from another department, who was also on the verge of getting fired, helped me change a lot of the audio files on Dan's upcoming video presentation to his most classic-sounding sound bites of making fun of Asian people, black people, telling sex jokes. The visual stayed the same, but the audio track was completely changed. Officially, Dan's dull-witted friend was in charge of creating the presentation, and he and Dan would take credit for the whole thing. The reality was that I was supposed to create the whole thing, make it a smash hit, and get fired without getting any credit for it. Every day, I was supposed to submit my work to Dan and his friend, and they were supposed to give their okay on my work. Our presentation room for the client is about the size of a classroom. It's basically like a private theater in a mansion. Our clients were about a dozen Japanese men. There's a movie screen on one end with a podium beside it. Dan was supposed to make a speech at the podium, then show how approachable and cool he is by pacing up and down the stage in front of the screen to really sell our agency's services, and then take a seat while the video climaxes the show. The video is projected from behind a glass room like a movie theater and back, and a projector is connected to a laptop beside it. The projector shows its image through a glass window. That projector room has one door accessible from inside the theater. It has a deadbolt lock, though it's never locked. Another door leads to the rest of the building. We're on the 8th floor. Only the custodian has the key. Dan had a remote control where he would click a button and the presentation would start. Without Dan knowing, I had the projector changed to a different model that wouldn't read his remote, but the remote I was holding. There were like 5 different projectors available in the projector room. The plan was supposed to be that Dan would press the button, the video would play its 3-minute length, and that would end our pitch to the client. My plan was that I would press my own remote at the same time as Dan. Well, Dan goes through his nauseating presentation, really kissing a lot of butt. He finishes his pitch and then on cue presses his button. As planned, I press my button. Oh, I ought to have mentioned before, but I'd gotten my hands on a copy of the custodian's key without anyone's knowledge, and I deadbolted the projection room door. The first minute of the presentation goes as planned, the correct audio playing about how our company is so wonderful, yada yada yada. Dan is lulled into security and relaxes in his seat. Then the fun part of the audio starts, where Dan tells a lot of racist jokes, makes fun of how Asians talk, how he screwed his boss's wife, how the company was worthless, and how he was the best employee. Dan panicked. Practically screaming, he runs to the projection room, only to find it locked, lol. The whole team, especially Dan and the doofus who claim credit for my presentation, are wondering what to do. They're trying to usher our Asian guests out of the room, but oh no no, they find it fascinating. LMAO. Just when things couldn't seem to get any worse, I open my briefcase and take out my stink bomb that I've been carefully carrying like a Fabergé egg. Now was my chance. With Dan and his crash test dummy friend now screaming for something heavy to break the projection room window, I kick the box down the slanted theater floor. Only seconds later, the entire room fills with a horrible stench. The video's over anyway, and everyone rushes out of the room during the confusion, but not before Dan threw a chair through the window and broke a $4,000 company laptop. Understandably, everyone in the office was wondering what the hell happened in the conference theater. The Japanese businessmen were livid and complaining to the big boss about having their time wasted by a recording of Dan being racist toward them and bragging about how he had sex with the boss's wife. They then left and took their business elsewhere. Dan was immediately called in, together with his underling. In the presence of an HR rep, they of course instantly tried to blame me for the whole fiasco. The boss then asked them, according to my HR friend, "Why are you trying to pin this on OP? Every day for the last 3 weeks, you and Crash Test Dummy Minion have submitted reports saying you two were working on the video presentation that was supposed to cap off the show. Are you admitting to fraud?" Needless to say, both of those losers were fired. One by one, my whole department was called into the HR office with the main boss to be interviewed separately, including me, of course. We all said we had no idea what all that was about. Everyone admitted that the audio recordings, which survived the broken laptop screen, were genuine, but no one could place who recorded them. All we knew was that one of us did it. The 13 of us who remained, 10 guys, 3 women, were in a group interview with the boss, and he thanked us for exposing Dan and his main underling. He told us that he wished we did it in a more constructive way, but that it was a positive thing that Dan was exposed for costing the company business. We were all given raises. My new supervisor's a much nicer guy. He hired my friend from the other department to join his after I resigned. HR told me that if I let them lay me off, I could collect 6 months of unemployment. I took it because I don't think I'll work in that field again. But in case I do, I got letters of recommendation from the boss and the new supervisor. Dan, of course, knew it was me who sabotaged his career. He's seen me around town before and knows I go to this cafe not far from where I live. One day, about 3 months after it happened, he saw me sitting at a table alone. He came up to me, looking like his failed jock self, and said, "You think you're pretty smart, don't you, you effing bee?" Then he started to approach me like he was going to use his physicality to intimidate me. There were lots of witnesses, mostly elderly. Lucky for me, my husband came out of the bathroom just in time to see another man looking like he was threatening me. Happy ending? Dan had a broken nose. No, I'm not going to press charges, officer. 200-foot restraining order? Yes. 7 senior citizens stayed behind to tell the police the husband, former football jock but now a quiet research scientist, was defending his wife. Give it up, Dan. You lose. Hey guys, thank you all for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one.